In this video, I'll explain how to enter standard plant counts online using the Atlas website, Nature Counts. Please note that this covers the methodology for 2021 field season. We're working on an updated methods that should be ready for the 2022 season. Also note that this does not include instructions on how to enter point counts using the more advanced methodology with the distance bands. That uses a different methodology, which we'll cover in a different video. Okay, so you're going to head to the Atlas website and log in. And then just like as if you were going to submit a regular checklist, you're going to hover over Submit and click on Submit Data. Now, the thing to keep in mind when submitting point count data is the process is optimized for doing multiple, like a morning of point count data. So if you're just entering a single point count, it's a bit clunky. But the idea is it's optimized so that if you're doing 5 or 10 point counts in a given morning, you can enter all that pretty quickly rather than re-entering the same information over and over again for each stop. So I'm going to show you how to do a morning of point counts. So what we need to do is we need to zoom in on the square where we conducted the point counts. If you've got it saved, you can click on the square to zoom right in. That's what I'm going to do here from my personal list of squares. And it zooms in on the square. It's going to show the eBird hotspots, those little red flaming icons, and then blue for places where you've already submitted data. Now, as I said, the process is optimized for multiple point counts in a given entry. So the way to sort of wrap your head around this is you're going to enter as a single checklist for your entire morning of point counts within a particular square. So keep that sort of framework in your mind that this is a checklist for all the counts that you did, all the point counts you did in the morning. So you can do it as a traveling count. You can do it as an area search, or the easiest way is probably just to use the use entire square option. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to scroll down. I'm going to select the date, May 25th, and the start time. So this is when you started your checklist. So when you started going out and doing your point count. So I start at 5 a.m. and I was out for 90 minutes till 6:30. There's one observer. And you can record your distance traveled. So this would be the entire distance you traveled within the square while you were conducting point counts. You can leave that blank too. Same with area. And then when you get to the, are you reporting a complete checklist of the birds you're able to identify? If you're just entering the point count data, click no. But if you're going to enter the observations of all the birds that you encountered between individual stations, point count stations, then you want to click yes. So that's what I'm going to do. And then, of course, the most important question to answer yes to is, did you complete Atlas point counts? So click yes. And then just so you know, there's this little tick box to show point counts locations. You can just ignore that. It will show the point count locations regardless of whether you check that or not, since you've selected that you are doing Atlas point counts. Hit continue. So the next thing that pops up is on the square, you're going to see all these new points. And these are the Atlas point counts, predefined point count locations. The ones that are numbered are the on-road locations. And then any that are letters, like you can see the A and B and C over here, those are off-road locations from Atlas 2. So those are ones you want to redo this time. So what you need to do is you need to click on all the point count locations where you conducted point counts this morning for this checklist. So I'm going to zoom in a little more and I'm going to click on the counts I did. So I did point count number 1, point count number 8, point count number 2, and I'm going to do point count C, off-road. And then I'm actually going to plot a new off-road location. So you can use the use coordinates button down here if you know the coordinates, like if you took a GPS reading. Or if you can plot it accurately, then you can do so using the map. I find it easier to switch to satellite view for that. And my off-road location was over here. And it was right in the middle of this deciduous forest. Right there. So I'm going to click it. Okay, so now we've got our 5 point counts that I did this morning. They're all labeled with a square ID, 17TQK11, and then point, and then the 01, 08, 02, those are the point count numbers for the station. And then C is the label for the station. That's off-road because it's a letter. And then we've got this new one that I just plotted. So because it's an off-road one, I want to use a letter. So I'm going to start with the square ID. So it's 17TQK11 point. And then the next available letter is D. So I'm going to use that. And then I need to enter the start time for when I started the point count for each stop. So the first one was at 5:15, then 5:30, then 5:40, and then this one was at 6. And I'm just using tab to go through the different boxes to speed up data entry. You can use your mouse, but I find it easier just to use tab. And the last one was at 6:20. Okay, so I've entered the start time for each of the location. I've labeled that one that needed labeling, and we'll move on to the next page. All right, now the last page should look pretty familiar to you. This is just like entering a regular checklist in terms of entering the count and the breeding evidence. As far as a regular checklist, the big difference is you've got your point counts here and separate columns. So you've got your start time, the point count location ID, the 1 to 3 minute time interval, the 4 to 5 minute time interval, and then again for the next one, the next one, next one, next one. So I'm not going to enter all the data. That would take too long to show you right now. But you're just going to enter your counts just as you collected them. So Canada geese, I had 1 in the first 3 minutes of that count, and I had 2 in the last 2 minutes of this point count. So as you can see, as I entered those numbers, the total was populated. So we've got 3 between those 5 point counts. Now there's another count column, and this is where you would record the count for number of individuals of that species you encountered between point count stations. So you don't have to enter this, but if you're doing that complete checklist for the whole morning, then please do enter your counts here. And if you answered no to that, are you entering a complete checklist, then you don't have to put those in. But if you can, that's even more helpful information. So I did have a flock of 20. And then the last thing you can do is you can do your highest breeding evidence code between the 5 point count stations and the incidental stuff that you encountered between stations. So this one, I did have some fledged young. So I'm selecting that. You can add details just like you would on a regular Atlas checklist. So if it's a rare species or you just want to add more information, use the add details. And if you were doing more than 5 stations in one checklist, which is totally fine, you're only going to see 5 at a time. To jump to the next set of 5 stations, you just select from the show point count number. And there'd be then an option 6 to 10, 11 to 15, and so on. So that's it. It's pretty straightforward. The main thing is to get your head around the fact that it's optimized, as I said, to enter your data for several point counts all at once. So the whole squares point counts from a single morning. If you collected 5, 10, 15 point counts in a single morning, it makes it easier because you don't have to re-enter the information over and over again. You just have to put in the different counts. So the last thing you need to do, of course, is click submit, and that will flag anything, if you had any high counts or records that you need to add details for, it'll prompt you. But otherwise, it's all just like entering a regular Atlas checklist.